Whisper Gaming ASMR, and today we're going to be playing a game that I've been excited about for a while now. It is the beta for Diablo 4, and I'm also going to be eating hard candy while I play this one. You can tell I've been picking up my favorite flavors because of Jolly Rancher, because I just pulled out a watermelon. So it looks like one fell out of the wrapper, and I have a loose Jolly Rancher that's stuck to a bunch of them. Hopefully my fingers aren't too sticky now. I guess I'll be starting with a green apple. Today we'll be playing Diablo 4, the open beta, and I did the intro a little bit, so I'm up to level 5. The intro had a lot of cutscenes. It wasn't very exciting since I only had one ability. I mean, I still only have two abilities, but we'll see. I don't even know if I'm at the prologue yet. So I'm playing as a druid. Right now, with the skills I have, I basically turn into a werebear. And my game also did crash. So I already did this, I already unlocked the chapel. And that's where I left off, so I'm gonna unlock the chapel, which starts a cutscene. And I'm gonna probably skip the cutscene. And I've already seen it. Okay. My character's name, I guess I'd pronounce it Lear. I just did it one of the randomly. Like, you press a button, it gives you a random name, so I went with that one. How did I get out here? It's like the second time my character has passed out in the beginning of this. So it seems like some demon called Lilith seems to be the main antagonist in this game so far. Diablo 2 as a kid. My main character was a druid. I also had a necromancer. So I do want to try a necromancer in this game. Yeah, I played it a lot as a kid. But I never quite beat it. I got to the point where you fight Diablo. And I think I was leveled up enough to fight Diablo. I was always too afraid to fight him, so I didn't. I'm not gonna do too much dialogue in this. Also saying a lot. But yeah, so I've been a fan of the Diablo series for quite a while. I think I might have tried Diablo 1 once after I played Diablo 2, but I never really got into Diablo 1, but I played Diablo 2 a lot. Someone watching this, because I'm saying a lot. altar of Lilith. They grant permanent stat boost to all characters on this realm. Interesting. Diablo 3. I started playing it on PC when it first came out. I can't remember if I beat the main game. I don't know if I beat the DLC. I remember getting to the DLC area, but I might have not beat the final boss. And then when Diablo 3 came out on Switch, I played it a lot on Switch. I don't think I got as far. I think I played the adventure mode a lot, which you just like did random quests and stuff. But I had a lot of fun with that. And a little bit bummed that this one isn't coming to Switch. Oh, nice little mini boss. Bear versus bear. Switch version is it gave you like you could do a combat roll to dodge stuff, which it seems like they've kind of taken that for this one for the PC, and now you have like an evade that you can do. It has a cooldown on it. A blast wave shrine. But it seems like this one has more periodic damage nearby enemies. This one has some like MMO features in it, from my understanding. The werebear is very cool, I think. How long does this last? Apparently those deer are immune. Research into the new features of Diablo 4. Again, before I started this channel, I really wasn't playing any video games at all for the past year at least. Probably the last time I was really in, not even really into video games, but the last time I was regularly playing video games was at the beginning of the pandemic. I bought a PS4 Pro for this game, Dreams. Zach, let me make sure I kill this guy. I bought this game, well, I bought a PS4 Pro exclusively for this game, Dreams, which is basically supposed to be like an art creation tool where you could create games or music or videos or animation. You could create a lot of stuff in it. And I bought a I have a tendency to buy game platforms just for like one game that I get really excited about. So, kind of an odd choice that was what got me a PlayStation 4. Was there even anything in the cellar? I didn't even really get anything good, did I? Hammer that sucks. Did I get that from in here? But yeah, odd choice to go out and purchase a PS4 Pro. I did get it used at Game. GameStop, so I got a pretty good deal on it. But yeah, it wasn't even a $50 game, it was like a $39 game that was pretty obscure. But luckily I got that right before the pandemic. So, when the pandemic started, I went through some classic PlayStation 4 games I'd never played, so I went through Gears of War, not Gears of War, God of War, which I thought was pretty good, and I also played The Last of Us, which was good. It was very surreal. So I'm gonna pop in another candy because this one's not producing much sound. Christmas a lot one year with my friends. But yeah, so basically those are the, I don't know, I don't even remember how I got on this tangent. But those are the last games I really played. Up until starting this channel. I think that's what I started with. Sorry, this is definitely a ramble video. Short story long, I haven't done much research into the new features of Diablo 4 because I haven't been playing games up until about a month ago. It would not be Diablo without some giant spiders, or I guess a fantasy game in general. Spider host, I do not like that. Oh god. Come on. The werebear is pretty cool, I think. I know I already said that, but I still think it's pretty cool. Also, I don't know how I feel about this, it does kind of simplify things, but if you're not familiar with Diablo, traditionally, maybe Diablo 3 didn't have it, maybe it stopped with Diablo 2, but different items took up different amounts of inventory slots, and you kind of, it was almost like a puzzle. You can traverse through marked areas using, have to like kind of move things around in your inventory to make the most of the space, because some things would take up like six slots. slots. Some would take up four, some would take up two, some would be long, some would be wide. And it was almost like a little Tetris mini game, which I guess maybe it's good they got rid of that. Inventory management isn't a super exciting aspect of a game, I guess. God, I really don't like that spider host. Used to have to buy healing potions as well. They weren't something that you just like replenished. But they changed that in Diablo 3. I think Diablo 3 it was just on like a timer. But Diablo 2, there are a bunch of different potions that you could get. Or maybe not a bunch, but there are several different types of potions. You had mana potions and I think stamina was a different resource for like Amazons and barbarians. Maybe it did. unlock like an exclusive cosmetic for the full game, which is kind of cool. It's like a little wolf puppy that rides on your back. I think this game would also be fun to play with friends. Like most Diablo games, but probably not gonna record ASMR videos if I'm playing with friends. Seems like the road is blocked, but I feel it'll clear up when the storm passes. Let's throw in another Jolly Rancher. Another watermelon, jeez Louise. That's the thing with anything with multiple flavors. Even if you don't consciously do it, you avoid your least favorite flavor, and then by the time you get to the end, you just have a bunch of the ones that you don't like. It's not like watermelon's disgusting, but it's clearly the worst Jolly Rancher flavor. An odd assortment of empty bottles. Some of them still reek of strong spirits. I've also always wondered why liquor is called spirits. If someone knows the answer, please enlighten me in the comments. Is it because it like emboldens people or raises spirits? Or do people think that like getting drunk possesses you? Or does no one know where it came from for sure? Because I could probably Google it, but just never have. Also kind of gives me an urge to play Borderlands, because it's like one of those looter shooter games, or like this, it's just all about getting random loot all the time. I really liked Borderlands 1 and 2, but kind of dropped off after that. I haven't heard great things about the third one, at least story-wise. I tried playing the pre-sequel with some friends, but we never got very far into it. I played a lot of Borderlands 2 with my friend one summer. So, if you'd like to see Borderlands 3, let me know. But right now, I think I'm gonna add Slime Rancher, because I already recorded a couple videos that were unusable, unfortunately. So our recording settings got messed up. And I was looking at the most popular games that people watch streamed right now. And I'm sure this has been popular for a long time, but I did see that Grand Theft Auto 5 is one of the top games, and someone has suggested doing Grand Theft Auto 5, so I think they'll probably bump that up in my priority list. It just doesn't seem like a very calming game, and I've only played it offline, I've never played it online. I just can't imagine I'm gonna be very good, but I'll try Grand Theft Auto online, and if it doesn't matter, maybe I'll play the single player mode, if people are okay with that. Okay, let's see what this hermit's all about. Let's check out all his stuff. A healer's tool, they look freshly used. Mushrooms, organs, not for cooking. No. Can I steal from this? I can't loot this guy's chest, that's lame. Whatever is brewing, it smells awful. That's lame, I can't rob this guy. Oh. Ice level 6. Thank you. it's Deckard Cain. Maybe he died in the third one, I can't remember. We'll see when I get to a natural stopping place, but probably between 45 minutes and an hour. Also seems like a lot of these places have kind of like Russian or Eastern European sounding names, which is interesting. Definitely new. What's up here? definitely have to do gum chewing, because I'm already at 3 Jolly Ranchers at almost 11 o'clock, and I don't want to eat like 10 more. I'm going to record a few of these videos back to back, since the beta is only available for a couple days. I got to kind of squeeze in as many as possible. I wonder if there'll be another beta before this releases in June. Okay, I'll do one more Jolly Rancher. And when it runs out, that's when I'll end the video. Favorite flavors in this video. But it's hardened sugar. It's not like any of them are bad. A new totem. Harmonious crude totem. 2.5 spirit cost reduction plus 2 to all stats. Suck is this game doesn't have any offline option, and you also can't pause it. And if you let it idle for too long, you get kicked out, which hopefully shouldn't be as much of an issue in the full game, but when my game crashed, I had to wait like almost 40 minutes to get back in. Promotion I want to throw out there is one of my favorite bands released a new album today. I mentioned them in a previous video because I'm planning on going to this very expensive music camp this summer with the members of this band, but they're called Nickel Creek. And they released a new album called Celebrants that came out today. I haven't listened to it yet, but all my 57 current subscribers, just wanted to plug that. If you like acoustic or something like really folk, it's like, I don't even know, very intricate bluegrassy folk Americana. I know they're just like very, very talented acoustic musicians. If you like that type of music, definitely recommend checking them out. I will admit, even as a big fan, I usually have to listen to their songs a few times before I really like them. Oh god. Because the music is, I mean, not to sound like pretentious, but it's like pretty complex musically, and I feel like it takes a while for my ears to like adjust to it and really process everything that's going on. But yeah, that's my recommendation for the day. I have a long drive. I'm driving back home on Tuesday, which is like an 8-hour drive, so I'm not sure if I want to keep the survivor alive. not sure if I want to listen to it before or wait until my drive to listen to the album. I'm still trying to decide. Have some more abilities rather than just right and left clicking. Wonder what I'll get for a reward for this. Two-handed thing. See how that goes. I gotta sell some of my shit. Guess I'll just drop my crappiest stuff. Something. Guess I can't go up there. It's also been nice to record at night. Things have been much quieter outside and within my apartment building. I recorded a Minecraft video this morning and there's a lot of loud disruptions. Lumber axe. one charm of a shaman. Well, devilish are easy. Multi-shot. One more skill point and I'll have that stuff unlocked. Damage reduction while in wear bear. Critical strike chance against closed enemies increased by 3%. Basic skills generate 10% more spirit. If an enemy is hit by maul, just increases damage by 1. That doesn't seem super great. What's this do? Just 5 more damage. I guess I'll do this one. So close to 45 minutes, I guess. I still have like a little sliver of a Jolly Rancher left. I guess I'll try to stretch it out for another minute and a half. Oh, didn't mean to do that. Good thing I can't murder that guy. Anyone, whether you do ASMR or not, I assume you probably aren't an ASMR artist as well, but if anyone has any recommendations on some like really hard candies that last longer, please let me know, because these Jolly Ranchers kind of aren't cutting it. Maybe like a Jawbreaker or something would be better. Probably last a lot longer. Oh, looks like we are at the town we're supposed to be accompanying this guy to, so seems like a good place to call this video. I hope you enjoyed the hard candies. I hope the sounds were good. Again, I never know on the hard candy videos if I should talk more or less. Well, not more. I wonder if I should talk less so you can just focus on the candies.